So welcome back to Electric Vehicles Channel, my dear friends. I am Krishna Chaitanya Mandela, and today's guest is the CEO of Aslo EV, Mr. Mohit. So firstly, Mohit, thanks for joining with Electric Vehicles Channel.
Yeah, it's good to be back again, and my warm greetings to all the viewers of EV channel.
Yeah, Mr. Mohit, here is my first question to you. Just imagine this electric two-wheeler industry as a jungle. And from the last 4 months, if you look at the number of pre-bookings for electric scooters, we need to admit that Ola S1 Pro is a lion, Simple One is a tiger, ETA 450X is an elephant. But where is Hyena? Is Hyena hiding inside the jungle? The customers are asking, the hiding of Hyena M1 is to attack or to defend?
Well, I don't know about the attack or defense. Like, we are on a strategy and we are acting according to a strategy. And it's not about we are hiding in a jungle. We are riding in a jungle because till now, no startup has rolled out scooters to the customers. And we are the first startup to roll out the scooters straight away after the launching. And we are the first one to have the customer reviews. It's not about what we are claiming. It's about what customer, like what kind of like the ride experience they have. They are free to they already have the videos, and soon we will be outing, like letting them out in the public domain. So, and moreover, it's not a jungle, it's just like a big celebration. Like there are a lot of cuisines available. Some people, they like Italian, so they will go with a different dish. Some people like maybe Chinese, so they will go with a Chinese dish. So it's like a win-win situation for the customers to have many brands in the market, and so they have got a wide range to choose from, and it's up to them. Like it depends upon their preferences, like what kind of brand they want to go for. And even if it's a jungle, then Hyena has more survival rate than lion, tiger or elephant, because they are, these animals are, they are found only in the limited geography. Like they are not found like on every part of the geographical area, and they are restricted to a difficult, like a typical geographical locations only. Whereas Hyena you can find anywhere. So that's the my comparison, like you asked me.
Okay, and see, let me practical now. In the current petrol vehicle industry, if a customer want to buy a petrol vehicle like a Pleasure or Activa or Axis, any scooter, they can directly visit a showroom and they can pay the money, they can buy the scooter. But now for electric scooters in India, they need to pre-book first, they need to spend some money, again they need to wait for test rides, again they need to wait for the delivery dates. Even your Hyena M1, customers has to pay 5,000 rupees as a pre-booking amount. Isn't it a little high?
I mean, compared to the price of the scooter, it's nothing. I mean, I think it's a very humble price, and like we are not in the like the race of getting the booking, early bookings, and so like 5,000 is, I think, pretty decent amount for a booking. Of course, we could have been like there are companies who are like offering bookings at 500 rupees or like maybe a little more than that, like some 699. It's up to, solely up to the like company, like what kind of strategy they are following to attract the customers, keeping a like lower price tag for bookings. So probably the chances are more that more and more people may find it like it's the price is less, so I mean, why not just book it? So that's a kind of a marketing strategy. It has nothing to do with the USP of the scooter or any other feature. Like,
okay, now coming back to the electric vehicle industry, currently there are well-established companies like Hero Electric, Okinawa, Aether Energy, even now the recent sensation Ola Electric, and upcoming Simple Energy, Ampere Vehicles, Pure EV. With all the competitors, what is your belief that a customer will go for Hyena M1?
Of course, there are many brands that are in market, but apart from that, Bajaj and Aslo are the only companies who are offering two-wheeler in complete carbon steel body, and that's basically that sets us apart from our other contemporaries. And secondly, because we have used Indian OEM parts, so availability of spares will never be a problem. Like customers, with less waiting period of time, they can have their hands on the spare parts if at all it's required. And thirdly, because we are using a mid-drive motor, the ground clearance of the mid-drive motor is much higher when compared to the hub motor. So definitely, extreme seasons like monsoons, we have a better chance of survival.
Okay, moments ago you mentioned that your Hyena M1 is actually riding inside the jungle. But isn't it very limited amounts? Because for example, if there are 100, take for an example, if there are 1,000 bookings, you are able to supply very few units to the customers. Is it because of the funding issue for Aslo EV, or whatever the other companies are claiming, the semiconductor shortage?
We are a startup, we are on bootstrap funds. So, of course, there are some limitations we are not in a hurry to get the investments because with whatever team we connect to, should have the same ideology like us, we are more focusing on customer satisfaction with whatever customers we are connected to, though they may be less in number as of now, but we want to give them a premium customer satisfaction there is from recently 2-3 months of time period, there has been some shortage in the market of course whatever the parts that are being imported from outside, also there has been a price hike on some spare parts.
Your Hyena M1 is also a made in India scooter, right? So you're also depending out of India.
Basic part of any EV is a battery pack. So still every startup is depending upon the supply of the batteries that is coming from outside India. So there has been some interruption in the past few months. There has been limited stock coming to India, and after the stock has arrived, now it has to be created. Each and every cell has to be inspected. So again, it takes a time come into the market, make it into customization and offer it to customers. So of course, all these reasons are accountable.
Okay, so apart from these things, if you got the right amount of funding, Aslo EV is ready to scale up?
Yeah, of course. Every startup, they are desperately looking for funds, to survive in the ecosystem. And we are not an exception. So the more money you put into your infrastructure, the more output you will get it, and more market you can cover, more customers you can make happy. So that's the thing. But right now, with whatever customers we connect to now, we just focus on those customers, right? And
may I know how many electric scooters you have delivered so far?
We have delivered 73 electric scooters all over India, and we have customers who have paid 100% advance and are ready to wait for months. So I think till now I haven't spent it much on the marketing budget. And so customers are only getting me more bookings. So that's the beauty thing. Mouth publicity, I think it is a better form of marketing. It has been happening from ages.
Now coming to the other companies startups in India, your co-startups, what is your comment on Ola electric scooter and Simple One electric scooter?
Of course, they are big players. They have got a good ecosystem around, and they have support of investors, and I'm sure they are they will deliver premium quality to customers, having so much of big infrastructure. So, and definitely they are also playing an important role in promoting EVs. So who is good, who is bad is not a question. Everyone is here to promote EV, and as long as they are anyone who is on a mission to on such kind of mission, so always they have the wishes.
Okay, and here are some of the subscriber questions for you. the subscribers want to ask you, how many kilometers of testing does Ashlo EV made on Hyna M1 electric scooter batteries?
I have clocked almost like around 2000 kilometers on my EV. Like what? The first scooter was used by me only. I only tested the scooter. And so at least I can be sure of about 2000 kilometers, nothing happened, at least in my scooters. And there are many customers like who are riding it in different parts of India. So
do you think that 2000 kilometers sample is enough to prove your electric scooter in long time survival?
I mean, this thing happened very early. Like, I mean, lithium ion phosphate batteries, lithium ion batteries, hardly it has happened maybe 2 years like in the market, like they have been used on such a wide scale, na? So I think after 4 years anyone can claim about like he has used and or like he has used the battery pack to its fullest life cycle. So till now I think
it's a good sample amount of kilometers as per you.
Yeah, I mean for testing, I mean 2000 kilometers is more than enough, like.
And okay, and what about the life cycles you are looking for your Hyna M1 electric scooter?
Life cycle we are offering up to like it depends upon first of all the riders like how they use the scooter, and if they use in a like according to the company guidelines like within the speed limits that has been prescribed, then of course I mean it can easily give up to 3000 cycles. And lithium ion phosphate, of course, 3000. They have a better life cycle than lithium ion. Apart from being the safe version, they have definitely more life cycles than lithium ion.
Okay, and how many bookings registered so far for Hyna M1 electric scooter?
Till now, like we have got some 2700 bookings, and I think that is of course, I mean, with whatever like inputs we have given in terms of marketing, so I think that is very much of like very much fair, like a number of bookings. And
so you're positive for the number. What are the 2700?
Yeah, 2700 numbers are the bookings till now as well as received. And it's not about no numbers, it's about like how many you are offering in the market, like at the first go, how many customers riding, that is the getting bookings, or like they are companies who have got more than lakh bookings. And so it's not about the question of booking, it's about how many quantities can be delivered in the market without making customers wait for a longer time.
Okay, and currently Hyna M1 comes with fixed batteries. When can we expect detachable battery option in Hyna M1 electric scooter?
Look, what I feel is a personal choice of a customer. I will not go with the, at least as of now, with the removable battery, because in the recent incident that has happened, that batteries, some lithium batteries, they have caught fire. I don't know what was the brand name of that scooter, but recently some of the scooters, they caught fire, lithium ion batteries. So I feel like whenever any electrical component is being engaged or disengaged now, so there can be a possibility where there may be some kind of loose connection between the two peripherals. And most of the accidents happens in any electronic circuit system when there is a loose connection. So I, even though maybe the risk is maybe small, but I will not, the Astro will not take even that kind of fraction of the risk, like. So in order to ensure complete safety of the customers, so we have opted for a fixed battery pack. Suppose there is,
but still if the customer insists to go for a non-removable battery or removable battery, for the example they want to go for removable battery, will you allow them to give that option?
Yeah, of course. I mean I will increase customers, like I mean I think in coming days my government has taken enough steps to ensure the charging points now wherever you are parking your vehicle. So if you have a charging point there, no need to take the battery, that plug the battery out and take it to your I think it can be available right at the
No, it's not about actually the charging station infrastructure, it's about the home facility. Most of the customers usually stay in apartments, second floor or third floor. So it's difficult for them to take the vehicle to the second or third floor. That's the reason customers are asking for the detachable battery pack.
Yeah, they can be, but as of now, we currently we have only fixed battery pack. But in future, ma, if we have some like with having more safety, like I don't know how to answer this one. Yeah. No, honestly, yeah, the, what is the? No, I will not. No, for to make customers happy, I cannot. Like I cannot simply give swap because that poses definitely a risk. And whatever the risks, things have happened like the recent past, na, it's all because of the loose connection between sockets only.
So, what is the maximum load capacity for on Hyna M1?
Hyna M1 has, other than the rider's weight, Hyna M1 is having 200 kilos of load capacity. And,
okay.
And without any drop in power, you can easily pull on 200 kgs of load.
Okay. Does Hyna M1 comes with reverse mode and hill assist?
No, it doesn't come. You know, it doesn't come under, it doesn't have the reverse mode and what was the other feature like you told?
Yeah, hill assist.
Hill assist, na? So yeah, the, yeah. No, it does not come with a reverse mode, and because we can, people can simply get down and they can like by minimum manual efforts they can pull back the vehicle, and reverse mode is for the heavy vehicles like three wheelers or four wheelers. So having
so it's a light vehicle, so it doesn't need that reverse mode option.
Doesn't need that, and in fact, reverse mode poses a risk. Suppose. You have some reverse, like it is in reverse mode and gone, like suppose like you tend to give accelerator and unknowingly the scooter will move backward, like so definitely it poses a lot of accidental risk. And it, yeah, of course, I mean the motor is very like having like of course the motor generates enough power to even climb the hill, so we don't have a separate hill assist mode. With a regular mode only, you can easily like take it up the hill. So it's not a big thing for us, for the scooter.
Okay. And finally, are the components, whatever the components used in Hyna M1 sourced in India?
I mean, apart from the lithium ion phosphate batteries that we are like, remaining every other component is made in India only.
So thank you so much, Mr. Mohit, for joining us with Electric Vehicle Channel and clarifying the subscribers' questions and your audience questions as well.
Thank you, Krishna.
For genuine information about electric vehicles, please to subscribe to Electric Vehicle Channel. And for fast updates, please to follow our Facebook page, website and Telegram group.